I'm Dr. Stream, a board-certified family medicine sports medicine doctor practicing in the United States. Usually, when it comes to knee arthritis recommendation, I tell my patients to use ice instead of heat for knee arthritis. However, in the last 1 year, I've changed my advice on this after looking at the research. So in this video, I'm going to discuss whether one should use ice or heat for knee pain due to arthritis. Without further ado, let's get started. So when we say knee arthritis, it occurs as a result of the gradual deterioration and degeneration of the meniscus and cartilage. So these both are essential supporting structures within the knee joint. So this process is primarily attributed to ongoing wear and tear on the joint. So patients with knee arthritis may present with varying clinical manifestations. While pain is a common symptom among all individuals, the specific presentation can differ. Some patients that I see experience extensive pain and swelling in the affected joint, while others may have significant pain without any swelling. Additionally, I've seen some individuals may report pain localized to the back of the knee or sometimes surrounding the front part of the knee region. Certain patients may also experience knee pain while weight bearing, particularly on the inner side of the joint. So these varied clinical presentation highlights one key point. So the pain that the patient presents with can be due to a different mechanisms in each patient. And that's why we cannot make a blank statement to say that ice is better or the heat is better. So back in 2003, there was a Cochrane review, which is one of the highest standards of evidence in evidence-based medicine. The key message on that article was that ice massage helped to improve the knee swelling, whereas heat did not have any beneficial effect. Now let us examine another study that was conducted in 2010. So in this study, the participants were given the option to choose between heat, ice, or heat-ice contrast therapy. So interestingly, all subjects experienced all three treatments, and then they were asked to indicate their preference. The majority of the participants actually expressed a preference for heat therapy. Furthermore, the study also revealed that the clinical outcomes, such as the pain reduction, improvement in function, were more favorable when patients received their preferred treatment option. So what this means is that, so let us say if a patient actually prefers heat therapy for the knee arthritis, then the heat therapy actually helps that patient. Whereas if another patient actually prefers cold therapy for knee arthritis, what the patient prefers is what actually helps the patient. Now let us examine another study that was conducted back in 2019, and this was a randomized controlled trial involving 60 participants. So this particular study did not discover any substantial advantages of using ice therapy when compared to placebo when it comes to assessing the pain severity, functionality, and overall quality of life in individuals with knee osteoarthritis. The placebo that they used here was sandbags. So overall, it is pretty clear that we need more studies to investigate this further, but again, I'm not confident that we might end up with a firm conclusion. So with that all said, here's my advice. So let us say you have knee arthritis and you have a knee arthritis flare-up which presents as an extensive pain and swelling. In that case, ice is the preferred treatment option. As we've seen in the Cochrane review, ice can actually decrease the swelling and thereby decreasing the pain too. So here there's uncontrolled inflammation and it's essential to put brakes on the inflammation. And the ice would do that pretty well. So we know that when you have a lot of swelling in your knee, it distends the joint capsule and that causes pain. So the goal is to control the swelling and thereby also decrease the pain. So during this time, I recommend ice for no more than 20 minutes at a stretch around the knee using an ice pack wrapped with a towel, or you can use frozen green peas. I usually recommend repeating every 1 to 2 hours. So during this time, I also recommend to perform exercises to continue activating the supporting muscles of the knee using isometric contractions. So don't worry, I'll attach a video at the end where I personally demonstrate how to do those isometric contraction exercises when your knee is swollen and painful. So let us say you have persistent knee pain but no swelling. In that case, you can explore both heat and ice therapy for your knee arthritis. So try both and see which one actually helps with your functionality and with your pain reduction. And if you find, let's say if you find heat therapy as helpful, then do the heat therapy. Or let's say if you find ice therapy helpful, then do the ice therapy. I hope this video was helpful. If you want to know more about how I treat knee osteoarthritis without surgery, then you will find this video really helpful. As promised, I'm going to attach the isometric contraction exercises that you can do when your knee is swollen and painful to get instant pain relief, and I'm going to attach the video here. And if you have any questions or concerns, please post in the comment box below, and I'll see you in my next video. Until then, goodbye.